It's week 11 of the SEC schedule, and we're breaking that down for you here on Tide 102.9, 100.9, the home of Alabama sports. James Hardy here, Marquise Munson here as well. James, what's going on, man? How's your week so far?
Been really good. Got to give a big shout out to Fatal Wound 77 for the radio voice comment you gave me last week. Pay attention to this week's picks. Big thanks for the compliment, though. As we got some big games to pick, especially not too far away from here over on the other side of the state.
Oh, absolutely. Two big games this week in the SEC, all involved ranked opponents. Well, we start with the other ranked opponent in the SEC, and that is the LSU Tigers. They're still ranked number 24 in the college football rankings after losing that game to Alabama this past weekend. Now they got Arkansas traveling to Death Valley. How's that game going to work out for the Arkansas Razorbacks?
Even with the loss last week for LSU, I think Ed Orgeron has to be really feeling great about his team as far as the direction that they're going in. It's a completely different direction for Arkansas, however, so for that reason alone, and with it being in Baton Rouge, I like the LSU Tigers to win big.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the LSU Tigers in this one. Their defense played really well against Alabama's running game, and they stopped that run game. Danny Etlin had a good game as well, a game that I didn't expect Danny Etlin to have against this Alabama defense. So I'm actually going to go with the LSU Tigers in this one. Arkansas, they're really not a good team this year. You can kind of make an argument whether Missouri or Arkansas is probably the worst team in the SEC this year, along with Tennessee. So I'm going to go with the LSU Tigers in this one. You got Louisiana. We're sticking to the Louisiana theme, and the Ragin' Cajuns traveling to Ole Miss. What do you got in that game?
Speaking of shout-outs, at least a former head coach of mine down at West Alabama, Will Hall, leading their offense as the offensive coordinator of the Ragin' Cajuns, has a lot of potential in the coaching industry. In fact, they actually gave Texas A&M, if you remember back in September, a pretty good ball game in College Station. And, in fact, I kind of expect them to play a pretty good game over in Oxford, but Ole Miss, I think, just has a little too much talent, even late in the season with not a lot on the line for Ole Miss. So I do expect the Rebels to win, but a fairly close ball game in Oxford.
Yeah, interim head coach Matt Luke has had a difficult task to begin this season. With all the scandal at Ole Miss, he had to take over for this team, and I think they get a win against Louisiana. Hopefully they can prepare for next season because, of course, this season's kind of a done deal for the Ole Miss Rebels. And speaking of interim head coach Randy Shannon didn't have a good debut last week against Missouri. Got blown out there by the Missouri Tigers. And now this week they travel to South Carolina. And will the Randy Shannon bad news continue, especially with Malik Zaire being at quarterback?
It will continue. I mean, they looked just terrible up in Missouri, the Florida Gators, last week. And South Carolina's been doing, in fact, had a respectable showing in Athens last week. I expect that momentum to continue, though, even after a loss for the Gamecocks. Come back home and get a very solid home W in front of the home fans at Williams-Brice Stadium against the Florida Gators.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the South Carolina Gamecocks in this one. Florida's looking pretty bad on both ends of the football, and although, you know, they've made the move for Jim McElwain to be out, and they're thinking that that's going to – hopefully they're looking for their new head coach, because as of right now, it's just not looking good for the Florida Gators. South Carolina's looking good in the SEC East, so I'm going to go with the South Carolina Gamecocks in this one. Speaking of SEC East, we have an SEC East matchup between the Kentucky Wildcats and the Vanderbilt Commodores. Vanderbilt has been struggling since that loss against Alabama. Kentucky, however, been having a good season so far.
Absolutely. Kentucky, even though they lost and had a disappointing home loss to the Ole Miss Rebels last week, Vanderbilt certainly a game that Kentucky has that opportunity to pick up their seventh victory because, hey, Vandy still doesn't have conference win yet. And I will still pick Kentucky.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Kentucky in this one. Despite this game being on the road, me going to Nashville again in that Alabama game, road games don't matter when you're headed to Nashville. And so I'm going to go with the other team here in the Kentucky Wildcats in this one. Now, another game we have is New Mexico versus Texas A&M. Now, New Mexico traveling to College Station. College Station hasn't been looking good as far as these home games is concerned, but will Texas A&M finally get a win at home this weekend?
Yes, they will, and it's a game Kevin Sumlin needs to at least have any shot of keeping his job, and Texas A&M needs for bowl eligibility, so give me Texas A&M.
Yeah, I'm going to go Texas A&M in this one. Kellen Mond, big game against this New Mexico State team. So I'm going to go with the Texas A&M Aggies in this one. No more home losses in College Station this season, hopefully, for if you're a Texas A&M fan. Now, speaking of losses, let's go to the Tennessee Volunteers. Tennessee Volunteers traveling to Missouri this week. Now, Missouri's starting to catch some momentum a little bit in the SEC, a little bit too late, but they're definitely catching some momentum. Momentum is something Tennessee is looking for.
But for Missouri, they still have a realistic opportunity of getting a bowl bid if they can essentially win out. And I think they have an opportunity still with the likes of Tennessee and Arkansas at least still on their schedule. And Missouri, especially with quarterback Drew Locke, who's close to 3,000 yards passing this year, I bet we'll probably get to that mark and well over that this week against Tennessee. I like Missouri.
I'm going to go with Missouri in this one. Tennessee has been looking really bad this season, and this may be the last of Butch Jones. Of course, we say that, but I think they're sticking by him at this point. But I'm going to go with the Missouri Tigers in this one. Drew Locke's having a good season so far. So I'm going to go with Missouri in this one. The big game of this weekend, though, outside of Alabama and Mississippi State, which you can head on over to Tide.com for those stat predictions. But I'm going to go Georgia and Auburn, the big game of the week here. Auburn, number 10 in the rankings now. Georgia still has that top spot. So who do you got in this big game in the SEC?
The South's oldest rivalry that dates all the way back to 1892. Kirby Smart's been in that Georgia program's been really impressive this year in Kirby Smart's second year back at his alma mater. And you look, at least for me, in these type of ball games with a couple of top 10 teams dueling from Jordan-Hare Stadium this week. And you got to go with the stars as far as the difference makers that need to be the difference in the ball game. And to me, you got to go to Nick Chubb and Sony Michel, and that's the reason that Georgia is going to pick up a big, big win.
Yeah, out of any two-loss team in the college football playoffs, Auburn has the best opportunity to make it to the Final Four. And it starts with this game this weekend, but I don't think they get the job done there. Even though they got two tough games at home, they got Alabama later on in the season as well. I'm going to go with the Georgia Bulldogs in this one. This Georgia team on both ends of football look very good. Running backs, two good running backs, two quarterbacks that you can even possibly put in the game. So even if Fromm does kind of, you know, go through an injury, you still have, you know, Jacob Eason waiting from behind. So this Georgia team just looks really good this year, and it's definitely going to set up a marquee matchup in the SEC championship with Alabama and Georgia. So I'm going to go with the Georgia Bulldogs in this one. And like I said, head on over to Tide1029.com for those stat predictions for Alabama, Mississippi State. Make sure you download that Tide1029 app in the App Store and also Google Play. And also, we're streaming games this week. So starting with the Mississippi State game, you can head on over to the Tide1029 app and you can listen to the Alabama game live on your mobile device. So that's why another good reason why you need to download that Tide1029 app. Make sure you also hit the subscribe button for the YouTube as well. Make sure you get all the good content from all our shows. I'm Marquise Munson for James Hardy. Thank you guys for tuning in to week 11 of SEC Predictions, and we'll see you next week for week 12 when we break down Mercer, the big game in the SEC.